The Pomodoro technique has changed the way I study. I used to study by sitting myself down and working on a project for a protracted period. The downfall of that method is that after a while, I simply ran out of focus. The Pomodoro technique addresses that problem. Fundamentally, the Pomodoro technique is to work in alternating periods of intense focus and rest. An example of using the technique is to set a timer for 30 minutes and work for that time. After that 30 minutes is up, set another timer for 10 minutes and spend that resting, like watching YouTube. Then you rinse and repeat. This allows you to recharge during the time you set out to be productive, preventing the burnout that occurs during long study sessions, and actually increasing the amount of work you get done. Another reason I like the Pomodoro technique is that instead of checking the word count of a paper every 5 minutes, I can gauge progress by the number of focus sessions I have completed. Somehow, this seems to make assignments fly by. The next topic I'd like to address is self-testing. It has been shown repeatedly that free recall, or forcing yourself to remember facts or answer questions without looking at your notes, is the most effective way to study. Self-testing is great because not only do you practice free recall when doing your pretend tests, but creating test questions for yourself forces you to ask yourself, what is the most important stuff for me to know about this topic? I like to self-test using sample questions from textbooks, resources on the internet, and making questions from my own lecture and reading notes. Personally, I think that long answer questions have been the most effective self-test questions for me because they force me to recall the largest amount of information. Lastly, I'd like to endorse the use of a calendar. Though it may seem obvious, a calendar has helped me immeasurably in the last few months. Personally, I use Google Calendar, so it translates to all my devices. Using a calendar helps me know when I need to study what my deadlines are, and when my tests or exams are. And though I've only been using a calendar for a relatively short period, in this amount of time, I've found that my procrastinating has been a lot less. I think that having my responsibilities visible and laid out in front of me helps me know when I actually need to get stuff done.